Hello, and welcome to the Daily Almanac for October 16th. So, let's get started.
First day in history!
On this day in history, October 16th, 1846, Dr. William Thomas Green Morton gave the first public demonstration of the use of the ether anesthetic, which the patient inhaled from a glass flask during an operation. An anesthetic is used to cause a loss of feeling during an operation. The use of ether for painless operations spread quickly to other countries. Also, on this day in 1859, abolitionist John Brown led a raid on Harper's Ferry, which is now part of West Virginia. He and his men took hostages and seized the town's United States arsenal and its rifle works. Why? Well, they wanted to abolish slavery by force. Brown was quickly caught and convicted of murder and treason against the state. He was sentenced to death by hanging. And on this day in 1987, Paul Hulk became the youngest person in the world known to have an organ transplant of any kind when he received a new heart at just 3 hours old. The heart transplant was performed by surgeons at the Loma Linda University Medical Center in California.
Word power!
Today on Word Power, we're going to take action. The word for today is verb. A verb is a part of speech used to describe an action. For instance, the man sings a little song. In this sentence, sings is the verb because it is the action being taken. Run, jump, play, twist, shout, laugh, and skip are all examples of verbs. Without verbs, we couldn't describe anything. We couldn't describe how we move or dance or tumble or read. Whew. I don't know who invented verbs, but I sure am glad we have them in our language.
Ooh, extremes.
Today on Extremes, we ask, what is the largest desert on the planet? The answer is the continent of Antarctica. Well, you might be thinking, Antarctica? But it's cold and covered with ice. Well, technically, a desert is a place that receives very, very little water. The Sahara Desert receives only slightly more water each year than Antarctica, but Antarctica is far bigger than the Sahara.
Health tips.
Here are some hair washing tips. Number one, before washing, gently comb or brush your hair to get rid of tangles. Number two, get your hair wet all over and use warm water. Number three, pour a small amount of shampoo into your palm. Don't pour it onto your head because then it can drip down into your eyes. Number four, rub your hands together to spread the shampoo evenly. If there's not enough lather, your hair probably needs more water, not more shampoo. Number five, really work your fingers to be sure you reach every hair on your head. Number six, clean all the way down to your scalp. Number seven, rinse the soap away completely. Otherwise, it can leave your hair dry and your scalp feeling itchy. Many cases about freedom of expression in schools are brought before the United States Supreme Court. One such case was Tinker versus Des Moines in 1969. Now, several students and parents in Des Moines organized a protest of the Vietnam War. The Tinker children wore black armbands to school to oppose the war, and they were suspended. Mr. and Mrs. Tinker filed suit, claiming that the school violated the children's right to freedom of speech and expression. The court ruled against the school district, saying that students do not shed their constitutional rights at the schoolhouse gates. Well, that's all the time we have left today for Daily Almanac. Thanks for stopping by, and I hope to see you tomorrow.